Lord be with you, and welcome to this New Year's Eve. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and peace at the last. Amen. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praise to your name, O Most High, to herald your love in the morning, your truth at the close of the day. Psalm 8. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. Out of the mouth of babies and infants you have established strength because of your foes, to still the enemy and the avenger. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you care for him? Yet you have made him a little lower than the heavenly beings, and crowned him with glory and honor. You have given him dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the heavens, and the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from the Revelation to St. John, chapter 21. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain any more, for the former things have passed away. And he who was seated on the throne said, Behold, I am making all things new. Also he said, Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. And he said to me, It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 25th chapter. Jesus said, When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on his glorious throne. Before him will be gathered all the nations, and he will separate people one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will place the sheep on his right, but the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me. Then the righteous will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? And when did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? And when did we see you sick or in prison and visit you? And the king will answer them, Truly I say to you, as you did it to one of the least of these my brothers, you did it to me. Then he will say to those on his left, Depart from me, you cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not clothe me. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they also will answer, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not minister to you? Then he will answer them, saying, Truly, I say to you, as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal fire. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. From Ecclesiastes chapter 3. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to tear, and a time to sow. a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. Time. Human beings are so foolish when it comes to time. We're experts at wasting time. Then we turn around and complain there isn't enough time for us to do what we want and need to do. But through the words of King Solomon, God assures us there is plenty of time, and there is a time for everything. God should know. He created time. In the beginning, God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night, and there was evening, and there was morning, what we now know as 24-hour span of time, a day. Then, so we could keep track of time, God gave us some celestial timepieces. God said, "Let there be lights in the expanse of the heavens to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let them be lights in the expanse of the heavens to give light upon the earth." And it was so. And God made the two great lights, the greater light, the sun, to rule the day, and the lesser light, the moon, to rule the night, and the stars. And God set them in the expanse of the heavens to give light on the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. Since then, the sun has measured our days, the moon has marked off months, and the stars have signaled the passage of seasons and years. And even though mankind fell into sin and brought sin's curse down upon the world, God did not allow that curse to corrupt time. After the great flood, God promised Noah that while the earth remains, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, summer and winter, day and night shall not cease. And time remains important to us. As one church father, Gregory of Nyssa, put it, "Time is the measure of pregnancy, the measure of the growth of crops, the measure of the ripening of fruits, the measure of navigation, the measure of a journey, the measure of the age of each person." Solomon calls time the universal measure for everything. So time is and remains a fundamental law, a natural order that God has built into his creation. The times Solomon enumerates in our text are set by God. So we should recognize these things as usual and appropriate. If we have problems with time, it's not time's fault, but our use and abuse of time that's at the issue. Tonight, millions of people around the world mark a milestone of time, the end of one year and the beginning of another. Actually, we could do this at any point during the year. December 31st to January 1st is just an arbitrary set of marks on a man-made calendar. Nonetheless, people will, for a little while, actually think about time. Some will do so with regret, most with celebration, anticipating getting rid of the baggage of 2021 and hoping things will be better in 2022. But for most people, nothing will really change. A few will make resolutions for personal improvements in the new year, but most of those will soon be broken. Before long, we'll all return to the times and rhythms of daily life. And as Solomon asked, in the light of all these proper times in our lives, what gain has the worker from his toil? Face it, anything we accomplish can be quickly undone. No matter how we react to life's problems and challenges, what difference does it make? Don't we continue to face the same things, the same times, over and over again? And just where is God in all of this? He's the one who created time and established times and seasons. What permanent benefit is he giving us through all these times? God answered those questions with another set of times that he's revealed to us. He made his own plans and preparations down through the centuries so that when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his son, born of woman, born under the law to redeem those who were under the law so that we might receive adoption as sons. Yes, St. Paul tells us, while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Through Jesus' death and resurrection, God has forgiven our sins and established a new relationship between us and God. He is our Father, and we are his children. Furthermore, God gives us a new life here on earth in which he empowers and enables us to struggle through the times we face, good and bad. And finally, at the end of time, Jesus will return and take us from this veil of tears to himself, and we will live with him in perfect joy in eternity. With all those precious gifts and more that have been given from the hand of God, which are you going to trust? Your times or God's times? Do you really think you can successfully run your life according to your schedule, your times? Or does it make more sense to accept and live according to what God has scheduled, his created order, his times? King Solomon said, "I have seen the business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time." Everything. Not just some things, everything. This is the Old Testament's way of saying what Paul said in Romans 8, "For those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose." Also, says Solomon, God has put eternity into man's heart, so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. Every person on earth has a natural knowledge that there is a beginning and an end of time, and that there's something after time. That knowledge, however, is incomplete without the Word of God. Only in God's Word does he reveal his creation, his redemption through Jesus Christ, and the new heaven and new earth spoken of in Revelation that's yet to come for all believers in Christ. Until then, Solomon says, "I perceive that there is nothing better for them than to be joyful and to do good as long as they live. Also that everyone should eat and drink and take pleasure in all his toil. This is God's gift to man." Did you hear that? God wants you to be happy. Not according to your schedule and your definitions of happiness. As sinful human beings living in a fallen world, we'll never find or create true happiness. We don't control our times, and we center our happiness in all the wrong places, ignoring the gift God gave us when the fullness of time had come. No, God wants us to be happy according to his schedule, his times, his gifts. And those gifts see us through the difficult times in this world when we cannot understand where or how we could possibly be happy. In those times, we trust not in ourselves, but in God. This is how we live our faith, day by day, month by month, season by season, year by year. We don't have to sweat the big stuff or the small stuff. We know that for everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. And all those times, all our times, are in God's hands. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, eternal Father and giver of every good gift, we commit to your mercy and forgiveness the year now ending. Forgive us our sins where we have done wrong, work in our hearts true repentance and faith, and redeem us from all the evil and hurts of this past year. You have shown us hard times and exposed many idols among us, yet if we are faithless, Christ remains faithful and will not deny himself. Help our unbelief, that we may know nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus. Hear us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We give thanks to you for the many mercies and gifts you showered upon us in this past year. You have given life, healed, and comforted. You have provided for our spiritual and physical well-being. You are the Lord of life and take care of us every day. All this you have done, not because of any merit in us, but only out of your love for us in Jesus, our Savior. Comfort and sustain all your children who suffer from any sickness, need, or affliction. Hear us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You have preserved this congregation in the faith for another year. We give you thanks for your blessing and guidance. Grant that by your grace we may continue to serve you in this place. Preserve the preaching and teaching in this place so that it is faithful to your word, and ensure that your holy sacraments are administered according to your commands and promises, and help us to reach out in love to this community. Hear us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Hear our prayers for our nation and its government. Preserve our republic, we implore you. Give health and competence to those who serve in positions of authority. Protect those who serve in the line of danger for our safety, and give peace in our time. Hear us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We commend to your blessing and love the times yet to come. Until you bring this life on earth to an end, guard and guide us by your strong arm. Lead us according to your word and renew us in us clean hearts that trust you and show love toward your neighbors. Hear us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hear my prayer, O Lord. Listen to my cry. Keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me in the shadow of your wings. In righteousness I shall see you. When I awake, your presence will give me joy. O Lord, support us all the day long of this troubled life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes, and the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations, and the glory of your people, Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. The Lord be with you, and have a blessed new year.